Hi, Charlie here. When an animal looks at you, you may assume that they're seeing exactly what a human would see. But this couldn't be further from the truth. Animals' eyes are absolutely amazing compared to our boring eyeballs. Their eyesight works totally differently depending on the animal. But in this video, we will take the place of animals and get to experience how they see the world. Birds. Birds have four types of cone cells in their eyes. These are called photoreceptors. Humans also have these, but they only have three. This allows birds to see the world in a totally different way. To be specific, birds can see the ultraviolet spectrum. This means pretty much all birds see with a purple tint. Birds can actually see many more colors than humans. But you won't really see that from a bird's perspective because most of the colors are obscured by purple. This is the case for pretty much all birds. However, there are a few exceptions. For example, canaries. Canaries can pretty much only see the color blue. Birds have enhanced visual sensitivity. That's because they have different mechanisms, including a one-to-one projection of receptor cells. That is when compared to the ganglion cells in their retinas. So birds aren't only seeing things from a bird's eye view, but they're also seeing ultraviolet light. Scorpions. Human and scorpion eyes could not be more different. Scorpions' bodies are studded with eyes. They have sometimes as many as 12. And in some rare cases, scientists have found even more than that. A scorpion's exoskeleton acts as one gigantic light receptor. They also have a full-body proto-eye that detects shadows cast by moonlight and starlight. This may surprise you, but remember, scorpions are arachnids, like spiders. They actually don't see any color, they see in black and white. And also, what they see is kind of distorted and swirly. This is because they have so many eyes. But quantity does not mean quality. Their eyes can only see the difference between darkness and light, and possibly movement too. Because scorpions' exoskeletons are a gigantic light receptor, they actually glow in the dark. That is, if you hold an ultraviolet light over them at night. As one scientist explains, scorpions' entire bodies behave like a human eye. Dogs. Okay, this is an animal you may have in your house. But how is your pet puppy seeing you? Well, unlike humans with three cones, dogs only have two. They have blue and yellow cones, but not red and green. Their vision can basically be compared to a human who's colorblind. It's a popular myth that dogs see in black and white because many think that colorblind means black and white. Some dogs' visions are also kind of blurred. This is the case with certain dog breeds which have been overbred. Breeders have prioritized the dog's looks, so that's why their eyesight is worse. Because dogs are virtually colorblind, they have other heightened senses. For example, they have a great sense of smell, which they use for navigation. That's why when dogs are searching around, you'll see them sniffing a lot. Bats. Everyone knows the saying, as blind as a bat. But like many idioms, this one is not accurate. Despite the saying, bats are not actually blind. This myth comes from the true fact that they use their ears to find food. This is a process called echolocation, meaning they use sound to find things. This basically allows them to see in the dark. But they do use their eyes for different things, for example, daily activities and social interactions. Bats pretty much only see in the colors red and black. This is because of the proteins in their eyes. Bats also use scattered polarized rays at sunset to calibrate their internal compass. This allows them to fly in the right direction when they're in darkness. So really, bats use a combination of echolocation, sight, the position of the sun and stars, and also the Earth's magnetic field to find their way. Flies. Looking at a macro image of flies' eyes is pretty mesmerizing. But despite looking kind of weird, their eyes are incredibly useful. Ever wondered why it's so hard to swat a fly? Well, it's because of their eyes. Flies' eyes can't focus. Their eyes are immobile, but because of their spherical shape, they can see a 360 view of the world. Their retina then relays information to the brain via their optic nerve. That's why flies can see your hand or swatter coming to swat them. Think about it like this. Humans have 20/20 vision, but a fly has 20/1200 vision. It also has the benefit of having around 4,000 lenses or ommatidia per eye. Flies actually have 5 eyes, and they can actually see various colors. Studies have found that flies are very attracted to the color blue, but the color yellow seems to repel flies. So if you're at a picnic in the summer, then maybe wear a yellow shirt. Flies also see the world with a kind of mosaic filter. This is because of the thousands of lenses which their eyes have. Rabbits. Rabbits can't see the color red. They also have a pupil area in their eye like humans do. But unlike in humans, it's not indented. This causes rabbits' eyes to have lots of visual noise, giving it a grainy effect. Also, because rabbits have eyes on the sides of their head, they can see in more directions than humans. Cats. Felines have many more rods in their eyes than humans. This means they can see a lot more in dim light. But human retinas have many more cones than cats. This is especially true in the fovea, which is all cones and no rods. This allows us to see a lot more colors than cats. We also see in a more detailed resolution. But cats have a greater visual field than humans. They can see a massive 200 degrees instead of the 180 degrees that humans can see. But this larger visual field means that cats' vision is quite blurry. Cats' tapetum mechanisms allow them to have a greater light detection. This means they can kind of see in the dark. Their photoreceptors are much more sensitive to colors in the blue-violet and green-yellow ranges. To give a good example of this, let's take a cat to outer space. This is how Earth would look to a cat in outer space. Shrimp. You may not think much of shrimp, but they have one of the most complex eye systems known to man. They have a whopping 16 photoreceptors, and their filters actually divide ultraviolet light into distinct colors. They're one of the only animals who can detect circularly polarized light. That's when a wave component of light rotates in a circular motion. They can also perceive depth with one eye and move each eye independently. Sharks. If you take a dive into some water and then open your eyes, everything will be blurry. You may assume that's the same for sharks, but it isn't. If sharks saw like this, then they would be very bad predators. They wouldn't be able to see their prey and would simply swim around with their mouth open, hoping to catch some fish. Sharks don't see any color, but they can see clearly underwater. They can focus because muscles surrounding their lens pull closer and farther away from their retina. They can also control the amount of light they're exposed to. That's because sharks can dilate and contract their pupils at will. This is something human eyes do automatically, but sharks can do this manually. This allows them to see a lot better in low and high light situations. And it's one of the reasons why they're such a feared predator underwater. Mosquito. Mosquitoes have eyes that can see shades of black and white as well as movement. They have lots of sensors which allows insects to zero in on heat. So, their eyes are basically heat-seeking cameras. Mosquitoes have two compound eyes located on the sides of their head. These eyes are covered with specialized lenses, similar to a fly, and these essentially function as individual eyes. Mosquitoes can only see things from around 10 to 50 meters away. But mosquitoes don't actually find you thanks to their eyes. They find humans to bite thanks to CO2. Mosquitoes can see infrared light. This is how they simultaneously find humans to bite and stay away from any predators. Goats. If you've ever looked closely at a goat's eye, you may have noticed something special. Their pupils are rectangular. This is actually good for goats because it allows them to have a better depth sense. It also gives them improved peripheral vision. They have split pupils, which controls how much light they take in. This helps them to make sure they're not blinded by the sun during the day, but also allows them to see better during the night. Goat's eyes basically have a dark tint in the day, but in the night, their vision is much brighter than humans. Mole rats. Mole rats live underground, so they don't have to use their eyes very much. But they can detect the difference between light and dark. Unlike moles, mole rats do have tiny external eyes. This allows them to see some colors, for example blue and green. However, they can't see red. Of course, this does not apply to the blind mole rat, which can't see anything. Snakes. Snakes can see some colors, but they can also see in infrared. That's because they have extremely sensitive infrared sensors located on their heads. This allows them to see their prey in the darkness. Rattlesnakes have one small pit on either side of their head. These are filled with thousands of receptor cells, and they're basically microscopic infrared sensors. Squids. The colossal squid has one of the biggest eyes in the animal kingdom. Their eyes face forward, and some say they're like binoculars. They have photopores. This allows their eyes to make additional light and see prey better in the dark. Worms. Many earthworms don't have eyes to begin with, but this doesn't mean that they can't see. They do have light receptors, which tell them the difference between darkness and light. They use these to make sure they know if they're above ground or below ground. When they're above ground, everything is very light for worms. That's because their light receptors are geared to being underground in the darkness. And also, everything they see will be very blurred. Now it's time to make your voice heard. Comment below which animal had the most amazing vision. If you want some more amazing videos, then subscribe to my second channel. But as always, thanks for watching. There are some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.